design of the batch reactor, which we have discussed yesterday, all the ingredients are there in this problem. Okay. What you have to find out is the reaction time. Okay. Yeah. And after calculating reaction time, then you have to add 30 minutes. That is the last line. You have 30 minutes required for discharging, cleaning, recharging, and all that. Then you have to calculate how many batches, and then you have to calculate what is the batch volume. Yeah, it is a reversible reaction, and equations are already there, derived and all that in Levenspiel book also, right? So you can, if you derive, then you will be more comfortable. If you just copy from the textbook, if I give the same thing in the examination, I don't give you textbook. Okay, so then you will have problem, and I also won't give marks if you are putting from memory. Okay, memory means only computers. Okay, so that's why if you recall from memory and then just write there, I don't give. You have to derive. Good. And the bracket A, B, R, S are the like A plus B going to R plus S. All liquid phase reaction also, constant density system. Everything is there. Good. Okay. Anything? Okay. Good. So that is the problem. Now we will start. Logically plug flow reactor. Why logically plug flow reactor? Why did I say logically plug flow reactor after batch? Plug flow and batch will be same under some conditions. Performance? Yeah, I mean, or both are same. And if they are same, why they are same? Logically, I said because the same equation under certain conditions is exactly same as batch reactor equation for constant density systems. Why they are same and all that, now you have to get that knowledge. Okay, why? And that with clarity, not simply, you know, like parrot, because everyone says that they are same or they may be different, then you are also repeating they are same, they are different. Right, but if I ask you why they are same, why they are different, not able to tell. So in this course, what you have to get is that clarity, all the cobwebs removed from the mind, clean house. Correct, no? So that is what I think. You know, definitely when you are going to choose continuous system, when you are going to choose batch system, that clarity has come. Okay, with examples and also with reasons and all that. So now in batch, sorry, in batch reactor again. How do you calculate volume, even though volume is not directly present in the design expression? That also you know how to calculate. So any batch reactor, the time is same. Even if you want to produce 5 kgs, 50 kgs or 5 tons, 500 tons, batch time is same. But depending on the production rate, you will have different volumes. Okay? Sometimes you may use 1 meter cubed, production may be less. Sometimes you use 5 meter cubed because production is more. So to calculate all that, only this problem is given. Okay. So plug flow reactor diagram, what we normally draw is something like this. It is a tubular reactor, it is a tube, right? And then something enters, something comes out, and we also show whenever you have plug flow reactor that we have like this, correct, no? Yeah. So like that, what is the meaning of that? Constant velocity. And this constant velocity, when do you get throughout the tube? Fluid mechanics wise. High, how high? Infinity. Because only at infinite velocity, you will have the velocity near the wall also. Same as that. Otherwise, as long as walls are there, there is no real plug flow reactor existing. Okay, without walls, how do you conduct the reaction? You can conduct in some heterogeneous systems. Beautifully, you can conduct. The true plug flow is there actually. You may not know that, but anyway, I will tell later that one also. Yeah. So this is how we have to show. We will show the plug flow reactor. Then normally we will say that we have FNR entry. And this one is final FAF, and here also you may have C A naught, V naught, and isothermal we are talking now, isothermal plug flow reactor, and temperature is same, that I do not have to write throughout because isothermal. Then what else is missing here? Of course, X A we can write, which is 0 there, okay, X A equal to 0. Then correspondingly here I have C A F, V F, which may be final, and also X A F, which has some value. If that is also 0, then beautiful design, no reactor, because where is the reactor there? Because X A entering 0 and leaving also 0, that is a wonderful design, because nothing will happen there. The sometimes, you know, not doing anything is safe. Good, okay. So this is what, and I do not know whether you remember any other names than plug flow.
Piston.
Yeah, we call piston flow. Any other name?
Tubular flow.
But
annular flow.
Rod flow.
Annular flow. Slug flow.
Annular means you have two.
One more.
Slug flow means it is only two phase system.
Two-phase.
We are talking about homogeneous. Okay, we have sufficient names, because don't invent slug flow and all that. That will not come. Slug flow will never be plug flow. Okay. So, slug flow we will discuss later when you come to heterogeneous systems. We are talking about homogeneous. Yeah, normally the names what you have already told, we may call it as piston flow, okay, and other name you said tubular flow. But when you say tubular flow, normally tubular flow, tube associates with the flow, where definitely at the walls you will have velocity equal to 0. So, that is why when you say tubular reactor, it does not mean that it is ideal plug flow reactor. If you want to specifically say ideal tubular reactor, okay. So, that means it is plug flow. What is ideality in tube? Our assumption is that we have flat velocity profile, okay. That only gives me that plug flow condition. So, piston flow, then ideal, yeah, tubular flow reactor. And rod flow also is rarely used, it is right, what he said is right, but rod flow also very rarely used. It is, that means it is like a piston is a rod, correct? No, see, if you look at the piston when it is moving through a cylinder, how it moves exactly, you have the cut there, okay, the piston the piston diameter is cut like this exactly. So then this moves like this, okay. So that is why we say it is a piston flow, because we expect in our tubular flow that kind of flow, like a piston flow, okay. So why should we assume that we have that kind of piston? So the ideal definition for this is that all particles must spend exactly same time inside the tube, okay, inside the reactor, each and every particle, okay. How do I imagine that? Okay, I will simply give you a very simple example, most of you would have seen that, okay. Yeah, before that I will also write time spent by each and every molecule is same in a plug flow reactor. Plug flow is always ideal. We do not have to again say that ideal plug flow, okay. Plug flow itself is ideal, okay. So then why we should have this name, you know, plug flow? The reason is that when you assume this time spent by each and every molecule, yeah, time spent by each and every molecule is exactly same, means that will be possible only when you have flat velocity profile or axial mixing equal to 0. Axial mixing means this is the axial direction, this is radial direction or lateral direction, okay. So in this direction there is no mixing. What do you mean by mixing? A molecule coming here and then again coming back and forth, okay. So that kind of thing is not allowed. Why? If a molecule comes here, there is a flow, continuous flow, you are sending continuously volumetric flow rate wise V naught, if you divide by cross sectional area then it will be velocity. So, volumetric flow rate wise it is going with constant velocity, okay. For example, first time we discuss constant velocity, afterwards we can extend that to what will happen if you have variable velocity also, Okay. So, constant velocity, and then the molecule comes here, and by some reason that will also may come back a little bit backward. So, that means this molecule which has been moving with some other molecules forward, now coming back and joining the molecules which have come later than this molecule. Okay, I think okay, maybe explanation is not probably you are not understanding. So, this molecule entered 5 seconds back at this point. Okay, at this point if I take that its time, it is 5 seconds. Now, there is another molecule which entered 3 seconds back, right. When you say axial mixing equal to 0 means this molecule will never mix. In reality, what will happen? This molecule, because of some disturbance, will come back and then mix with this molecule. That is not allowed in plug flow. Simple example is conveyor belt. But that velocity is with respect to what? Velocity of the conveyor belt is with respect to what? There must be some reference, no? Ground. With respect to ground, maybe the velocity of this conveyor belt is 5 kilometers per hour. Okay. Yeah, that is normal walking speed, that is why. All of you are standing there, just and behind you also there is another row, 3 people, behind you also there is another row. I am imagining you as molecules. So, 3 molecules, 3 molecules, 3 molecules, in reality there will be millions of molecules, but only just for imagination we are telling only these 3 molecules, just standing there, and then just you are pushed by the conveyor belt, where that is equivalent to for us here convection, the flow. So, this flow is simply pushing those molecules without any disturbance, simply like that. Okay. So, then in first minute your color changes to green, your normal color, this color. Okay. So, then after another minute then it becomes red, after another thing it becomes green, orange. So, like that by the time end if you go, so you may get some purple color or something that is equal to 100% conversion. Right? Easy imagination, no? Now, at any time when I look into this, people standing here will have red color. All of them are uniformly have red color. Okay? What is the meaning of that? That means the concentration, if I imagine that color as concentration, all that color is same for each and every person, and the concentration is same, yeah, at that point, at this point. So, that means what is the assumption we are giving without knowing also that the radial mixing must be infinity, we say, 100% or infinity we say. What is the meaning of that? Yeah, there is no change in the concentration, and that is happening because all the molecules entering in that row just moving are uniformly converted, not for 100%. 100% conversion is not occurring. At this point it may be 30%. But uniform. At this point it may be 60%, still uniform. At this point it may be 90%, still uniform. This is 100% if you get 100% conversion. So, that means whenever I look at the reactor across the cross section, lateral direction, we say that we have uniform concentration. When do you get uniform concentration in a mixer? When you have perfect mixing, then you say that I have mixing throughout the reactor same. So, that is the reason why even here at any cross section we say that we have perfect mixing, and in other words we will also say, because we are saying 0 there, the axial mixing, this direction, okay, axial mixing is something like this, right. Some molecule is here, again it will come back, some molecule is here, another, again it may come back, molecule here, again it may come back, same molecule may be coming backward and forward. So, that means this is mixing with molecule which has entered a little bit late, and again going forward, and again coming and mixing with some other molecules which have just entered there. So, all that mixing is called axial mixing, but in plug flow we say that is not allowed, ideal condition. So, now what we say is, we have this axial mixing equal to 0, in fact, which means that radial mixing must be infinity, we do not have to say again, but we say axial mixing is 0, radial mixing equal to 0, and then what are the other things we said? A flat velocity profile. Unless you have the flat velocity profile, all three conditions will not be satisfied. But three times we reiterate, okay, axial mixing equal to 0, same thing as radial mixing equal to infinity. These two can happen only when you have flat velocity profile. All three can happen only when you have time for each and every particle exactly same. So that is why the basic definition what we would like to remember is the time of each and every particle. Okay, yeah. Why they are same means without any disturbance, in the sense that all these molecules, okay. Now we will expand our imagination slightly more. Now I will say that I am now feeding the molecules continuously, but these molecules I am sending in the form of packets. Each packet may have some molecules where there is some concentration and all that. So that means at time t equal to 0, I imagine these are the molecules just entered. Okay, these are the molecules just entered. So now if we accept this definition like axial mixing equal to 0 and radial mixing equal to infinity, and of course the other one, what is that, the flat velocity profile, all that if I assume, then the same packets will move from here to here. Each packet now you can imagine as a very small batch reactor. Inside that batch I may have good mixing and all that. Okay, so our imagination, we are making smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller till individual molecules. But first let us, I started with molecules, but let us imagine that we have small packets, and in that packet the reaction is going on, and this we are not allowing them to move forward and backward, and that means axial mixing equal to 0, which also means that radial mixing equal to infinity. Then at this point, what is the conversion in each and every small reactor, that small batch reactor? Conversion, it is same, and that conversion depends on how much time it has spent inside the reactor. If it is 1 minute, some conversion, 5 minutes, some conversion. Now, let us say total time is 10 minutes required. For 10 minutes you may get 99% conversion. So at the end, if I see, oh, they have not become bigger, same, yeah, they may become bigger under some conditions also, okay. Same size, yeah. At this point, if I look, each and every packet also will have exactly, okay. Now slightly relax our, I think this is clear now, yeah. The turbulence and all that, when we say, when you know, you may have that very high Reynolds number, you have turbulence. What do you mean by turbulence there? It is not that turbulence what we are talking when a molecule here can suddenly jump here. A molecule here can suddenly jump here. That will happen if I have a tank reactor. If I have tank, like batch reactor we have studied. So a batch reactor you take, and then you put the all the reactants and then start stirring. Can you identify its location? You cannot, because one molecule may be momentarily at the bottom of the reactor. Because of mixing, suddenly it may come out, or again because of mixing, it may go to one corner, and again, you know, another corner. Like that, at any time, any point of at any time inside the reactor, at any point it may be there. In fact, that is the definition of mixing. You cannot say that, you cannot say that I have mixing but molecules are not moving. Okay, so then when you say that we have perfect mixing, the possibility for the molecules to move from anywhere to anywhere is possible for them. I mean, for the, because of the mixing. Yeah, Abdul.
Sir, we know that reaction happens by collision of molecules, and in plug flow it is highly limited. There is lesser conversion. There is lesser collision of molecules.
Why? How do you say lesser collision of molecules?
In the same thing.
If we let it deviate from plug flow. And let it come, let there be actual mixing.
No, but where do you say lesser collision? I think you say that the collisions are there only when you have tank reactor.
There will be some lateral mixing, sir, but
yeah, but even here, when the molecule level, what is the size of the molecule? How many molecules you can put in 1 inch pipe diameter? So there, yeah, so there is again, you know, all those collisions and all that is there definitely, but now that is not this way, but only this way. Why only this way? Only why this way? Because the flow is so good that it is not allowing anything to come back. any molecule is not allowed in this direction because of the convection velocity push.
If possible, we can allow it to even have axial mixing, so there is better conversion.
That is bad actually, because if I have a, I think that is a good question also, because so that others also will learn that if I am allowing a molecule which is already converted with the molecule which is not converted, what is the concentration now? We cannot say one molecule, but few molecules here they are converted 50%. Now suddenly they come and join here, mix, right? So then they are coming and mixing with these molecules. These are 25% or 30% converted. What will happen to the concentration now? It will go down. And what will happen to rate of reaction? It will be down, because I think rate is a function of concentration. See, first order, if you take very simple imagination, directly proportional. So that is why the concentration falls. This is the reason why the mixed flow reactor is inefficient. Correct? No, we know that if I take 1 meter cubed mixed flow reactor, 1 meter cubed plug flow reactor, 1 meter cubed mixed flow reactor will give me low conversion because volume is fixed, and 1 meter cubed plug flow reactor will give me high conversion. You know why? Now at least the reason? The reason is because of that mixing. So that is why here that same collisions are taking place, but that is only in that restricted region. Theoretically speaking, it is very, very thin, infinitely small region, not at molecular level we are talking. Molecule levels are very, very small. Okay, so that is the reason why we say that the plug flow reactor is more efficient than mixed flow reactor, because mixing always, you know, this is what many students will have this imagination that mixing is better for reaction. No, mixing is bad for reaction. Okay, perfect mixing is bad for reaction, but you are allowing the again, don't get confused. So here, even in this cross section I have perfect mixing, so that means at this cross section I have the same concentration for each and every pocket, because molecules we cannot say and then say concentration. Molecules are so many moles per unit volume only, that's what is the concentration. That is why this concentration is not diluted here in a plug flow. You already told me, no sir, the concentration slowly changes. Okay, very good, that is the definition of also plug flow. Slowly means how slowly? Only at each and every cross section only that concentration is changing slowly, not across. Okay, but definitely across means, I mean, at this point I have different concentration, at this point I have different concentration. So that's why when I plot this graph, concentration versus length, this is the length, then we will have, this is Ca naught. It slowly decreases, and you also know that, I mean, as I already discussed, that mixed flow reactor is better than mixed flow reactor is less efficient than plug flow reactor. We discussed that. The reason is this concentration, it is slowly decreasing depending on its time here, but across one cross section. So now next you have another cross section, okay, another concentration, next to another concentration. That means at every point this rate is maximum here, because assuming ideal non-isothermal reactor, I have first order reaction, K into Ca naught is the rate, or Ci is the rate. At time t equal to 0, just when it entered, what is Ca naught? Highest. So that rate is more. Okay, I am talking about simply A going to R, first order reaction. Then slightly inside, now it is K into Ca, but this Ca is highest. Okay, highest means it is not highest, not more than Ca naught, but next to next one it is highest. So like that, slowly it is, the concentration is decreasing. When you have slowly concentration is decreasing, the rate of reaction, you know, then that means I have one rate here, one rate here, one rate here, one rate here, one rate, so many rates, right? So all those rates, when you average them, that only gives you the overall conversion. Okay, but that is why the concentration of each and every at each and every point very optimally used in a plug flow reactor. Whereas mixed flow reactor, you are taking a one tank and then continuously putting water, reactants, continuously you are taking out, stirring is there, perfect mixer. So the moment you put Ca naught, then it is suddenly mixed, instantaneous mixing, because you have perfect mixing. What is the meaning? Everything is instantaneously mixed. Now, when you see the instantaneous mixing, do you see C A naught at all? Then you see slightly less than C A naught. Yes, sir? Yeah, how much slightly? What concentration you see in the reactor? Yeah, it is the outlet concentration. And outlet concentration is how much? 90%. So, your C A naught is suddenly decreased to 90% concentration, which is equivalent to your outlet concentration, right. So, that means all that concentration history gone. Like here, I have concentration history at this point, say okay, if this is 10 moles per liter, 10 moles per liter, this will be 9, okay, this will be 8, 7. So, at this end I will have 1 mole per liter. What is the conversion? 10 moles is 9, conversion equal to 90%, right. So, now, yeah, but that 90% occurring here through so many rates, correct, no, because concentration here different, concentration here different. So, that will have a rate, that will have a rate. What you see is the overall effect of that concentration at the end. Whereas, if you go to mixed flow reactor, where you take the tank and then just put, let me also, because for discussion I think I have to give this, yeah, continuously this is entering, continuously you are taking here. So, now here I have C A naught, here I have C A F, and by perfect mixing assumption, which is simple assumption, this is also C A F. And now you see there is no temperature history at all. Yeah, what is the plot here? Concentration versus C A naught versus length. There is no length actually, but I think you know space coordinate. So, what is that much now? Like this, and then you have CAF. So, all temperature history totally gone there. That is why to maintain this conversions, because given a volume, given volume, this conversion will be less, this will be more, right. But to compensate, let us say that you want to also get the same conversion like this, where concentration maintained, concentration maintained, every rate, all rates are average, and then you are not averaging, system averages, and finally, it gives you so much conversion there. If you want to compensate, what you have to do? Oh, no, that is different. The same one reactor, you should go for larger volume, bigger volume. So, that is why you see, we do not need any mathematics. Simple logic, we know that the volume of the mixed flow reactor will be definitely larger than the volume of plug flow reactor for a given conversion, that you have to always say, for a given conversion. For given volume, the conversion in plug flow reactor will be more than CSTR, okay, good. So, that is what is the plug flow, and that will happen only when each and every particle exactly moves like that. And now, I will give you another example. As I told you that you have heterogeneous system, I told you. You know, the coal is burnt using moving grates. I do not know whether you heard or not, coal for combustion. So, that will be something like this. You have a wheel here, which will be rotating, another wheel here, which will be rotating. Over this, you have the conveyor belt. So, this moves like this, comes out and then moving. So, now here I will feed coal, continuously I am feeding, and I will now calculate what is the time required for each and every part. Let us imagine that every particle is 1 centimeter, easy to imagine, okay, 1 centimeter uniform size, right. So, all the particles are coming there, and then by this time it comes here. If it is pure coal, you will not have anything, you do not have even ash. Ash also you will not have. Ash you will have whenever you have some silica and or minerals and all that, okay, then only you will get ash, otherwise no. So, that means each and every particle is entering, coming here, by this time at this point the particle completely disappears, right. Because you have now fixed the space, the speed of the conveyor belt, okay, at 50% of the time. That means, you know, if the total is, let us say 5 minutes, at 2.5 minutes at this point, each and every molecule, each and every particle would be uniformly converted. right, uniformly converted. Then when I look into this direction, that means the, yeah, so this third dimension, that is this flat plateau, this is moving like this, okay, this is moving like this, this is what the distance I told. So now at the middle, if I just see here, I will have the conversion of this the carbon particles uniform throughout. So at this point, if I draw a line and see the concentration, what do you say about that concentration? Same. That means radially you have same concentration, uniform concentration, that happens because of infinite mixing. See, that is what is the meaning of that infinite mixing there, because you know it is only uniform concentration. Normally, when do we imagine that we have uniform concentration? When you have mixing. So what we say for axial direction is the mixing equal to 0, right? And then in the radial direction, mixing equal to infinity, because you said 0 there, you are putting here infinity, right? But in words it is that the uniform mixing means infinite mixing, uniform concentration means that will only happen if you have infinite mixing. Infinite mixing means good mixing. How can you provide infinite mixing? I say there are many words which we don't mean anything, including love. And when you say I love you, it don't mean anything. But as I told you, know now explain to me, what do you mean by you, I love you? You cannot tell, that is a feeling. Infinite mixing means, you know, it is a good mixing, that's all, where you have uniform concentration. That is why those words infinite mixing and axial mixing equal to 0, axial mixing equal to 0, I will explain, that may be true, but infinity we can never see. The moment you see infinity, you cannot come back again, gone, you are gone to infinity. So that is the problem, you know, with these words. But still we use very frequently infinite mixing for radial direction, 0 mixing in axial direction. 0 mixing in axial direction is explained by this, you know, very clearly, that this molecule, this packet is not allowed to mix with this molecule, okay. And this kind of mixing, when you have, you will not have this condition. What is that condition? Time spent by, you cannot you know, have that condition. The reason I will tell you, the same thing, same mixing is happening everywhere, axial mixing, there is axial mixing. So by the time you come here, you will also see same thing, I am just pushing it there. So a molecule comes here and a molecule coming here. So now each and every molecule is not going and mixing with that, okay. So one molecule which is coming here may come out, other molecule which is about to leave may come back. So now what is the residence time of this molecule which has gone out, and what is the residence time of this molecule which has come in, and the average of that is 10 minutes. The average of all those timings, if I take, that will be 10 minutes, correct? No, you know, you have seen recently Olympics, 10 people are running, so few people will come faster, some people will come you know, just behind, and you add all those things and take average. So then we know that average run time for that event, we are not, yeah, that is what is the mean residence time here, okay. But some people would have come early, some people would have come late, right? But now when I have 10 minutes, there may be a molecule which has come in the 9th minute itself, and there may be one molecule which is coming at 12th minute itself here, right? So that is not plug flow. Why? Every molecule or every particle should come exactly at 10th minute, that is what is plug flow. If you have plug flow in Olympics, you have to give medals to everyone, correct? No, all of them are coming exactly at same time. But in chemical engineering, no, we do not allow that. All of you should exactly come out of the run with the same time, that is what we tell there. And if you want to have a feeling for this, I will tell same example. When you are walking, when you are walking, some people may be more enthusiastic people, they may move faster, they will push you aside and then cross you, correct? No, so that fellow may be going another 5 minutes, maybe 2 minutes before than you, and there may be very slow fellow who is having diabetes, heart attack and everything. So those people cannot move, so he is going behind only, not going forward. So those molecules may spend more time. So that is not allowed in plug flow. That is what is axial dispersion model. When you really allow that, because we have to allow that, because in reality you will never have plug flow. plug flow is only in our minds as a definition, but plug flow for heterogeneous system, this is the excellent example. You know, this conveyor belt, coal conveyor belt, perfect example is only this. That means you are designing this, and also, you know, perfect means I cannot really say perfect, because when you are designing this, you should design that without any vibrations, right, and without any sagging. You know, when you have this side one wheel, this side another wheel, when you put a belt, it will definitely slag a little bit, right. So without that slagging also, you should sagging also, you should design no vibrations. So what will happen if you have vibrations and allow this a little bit? Yeah, particles will be coming forward and backward. Okay, that is what is axial mixing, right? So that is why, and that kind of perfect design even for conveyor belts, I doubt whether there is any. That is why I told plug flow is only in our mind. But still, that will help us in design, you know, very beautifully, so that our volumes will be not exact, but you think it will give one extreme that okay, if it is ideal condition, this is the volume. If it is the real condition, like I have axial mixing, you need definitely more volume, right? Because of axial mixing, the concentration is decreasing. So instead of 1 meter cubed, you may have to use 1.2 meter cubed. Anyway, so when you are moving in that queue, if everyone is exactly moving with the same speed, without pushing, without pulling, okay. Correct, no? That cannot happen anyway. Those who entered there, that cannot happen. Without pushing, without pulling, then that is ideal plug flow. Everyone will see the God exactly after half an hour, if it is continuously allowed. Okay? But most of the time, it is not continuously allowed. They will put you in a place called cell. Okay? Cell, and then lock you. Yeah, that is a batch reactor. That's what That's what you are doing, you know, in batch reactor, you are not allowing any flow. So intermittently they do that. But I think after last cell, you are allowed to move. So when you are moving that, when you are moving in that queue, batch PFR. Okay. So then after, we are talking about only plug flow section when they are moving. So when each and every one is exactly moving with the same speed, no push, no pull, by the time you lose patience. Okay, because last cell will really kill your patients. By that time, you should have spent 10 hours or 15 hours, you know, the entering time. So that is why, and then you start pulling and pushing. Okay, so when you start pulling, the particle will go forward. Correct, no? You push them. So in that queue, there may be 5, 6 people or 10 people, you know. So if you are so strong, you will push them, all 10 move, or maybe one person will move forward. So that fellow will be very angry, he will say like this. So he is pushing them back. So that is why I said push and pull, you know. Yeah. So when they are, when this fellow is pushing them backward, then that molecule will come here. Okay. So now, a weak person may be moving always from here to here, here to here, here to here. That is what is the example of axial mixing. So next time when you enter the queue, remember plug flow and axial mixing. Okay, yeah, that is what, an ideal plug flow, that is not allowed. And of course, even with conveyor belt, we are so impatient, we will be pushing and pulling there also. Okay, so conveyor belt is to make them uniform time, but that I think proposal was not successful because there is not much space, all that I think. So that is why, maybe one day it may come, right. So that is another example for this axial mixing, but in reality, you will have that kind of pushing and pulling. That is the same thing in that is happening when you have tubular reactor, not ideal, tubular reactor. In tubular reactor, you have, now I am coming to your question, you asked me, you know, sir, there is turbulence in the packet bed. Yes, there is turbulence, but that turbulence in packet bed, plug flow is only limited like this. You can show that, no? You are showing, how are you showing turbulence in turbulent flow? How are you showing in pictorially? Yeah, but what is that? What do you call that?
Eddies.
And all those things are velocity fluctuations. We call them as velocity fluctuations. In ideal plug flow, what you are mixing is that, what you are imagining is that fluctuations are not allowed. Sorry? They should have. When we imagine plug flow ideally, then they should have that kind of, no velocity fluctuations are allowed in plug flow. Okay? So, that is why the turbulence is happening because of the velocity fluctuations. Because of the velocity fluctuations, why the velocity fluctuations are there? Molecules are coming backward and forward. And when they are coming backward and forward, they are losing concentration because they are converted to slightly higher conversion, but they are coming back and again mixing with lower conversion, I mean higher conversion, making that entire region is lower conversion, average conversion. Right? You know, average conversion is between these two conversions. This fellow gone here, the low conversion if you take the reactant, and again you are bringing him back and you are spoiling this fellow. This fellow has higher concentration, right? Back somewhere here. Okay? This is higher concentration, this is lower concentration. We are talking about only reactants. So, then you are in this region, we are diluting the concentrations. So, when you dilute the concentrations, rate of reaction will be lower. When you have rate of reaction lower, then naturally your reactor volume should be higher. Why? In all reactor designs, I mean, how many? We have only three reactors: batch reactor, plug flow reactor, and mixed flow, not so many. Yeah. So, in all these reactor expressions, if you remember, if you recall your memory, in the denominator you have rate. Okay. So, when denominator is smaller, then volume will be higher. Okay. I think, you know, the derivation of this equation is very, very simple if you understand this. Okay. Ideal plug flow is the, sorry, plug flow itself is ideal. Yeah. The plug flow what we are imagining in our mind to be in our reactors is like conveyor belt where no one is moving, like coal particles. Perfect conveyor belt without any vibrations, without any sagging and all that. So, that is what. Then each and every particle will spend exactly same time. So, when I calculate, I mean when I measure the concentration at any point across, then I will have uniform concentration. That means, I will say now that I have infinite mixing radially. No molecule is going forward, no molecule is coming backward. So, I will say axial mixing equal to 0, right? And then the other one, this one, time spent by each and every molecule is exactly same. So, all these things mean only one definition, that is time for each and every particle is same. Okay?